Good morning, students. How are you? Hope you all are fine. So, welcome back to your maths class. So, students, in this class, we will do revision because our tier 5 syllabus is complete. Okay, students, so be ready with your book. Take out your book. Yes. Okay, now open page number 51. So in this class, we will revise the topic measurement. You can see on the screen and also in your book, tick the taller or the longer one. Means you have to tick on that image that is longer. Okay. Now you can see this is a hut. Yes. And this is a building. Okay. Now which one is taller? Yes. Building is taller. You can see. So, we will tick on building. Okay, beta? Because this one is the taller. Okay? So, in this way, you can see in part A, you can see students which one is taller. Yes? Very good. So, we will tick on it. Okay? Like this. In B part, which one is taller? Yes, so it is very simple. Yes, you can do it easily. So now part C, D, E, F. You have to observe the pictures carefully. You have to see which one is taller, right? You can say taller or you can say longer. Okay, so you have to see which one is longer. You have to tick on it. Okay, students. So you will do these four parts. Okay. Now, come on page number 52. Now, you can see students and circle the shorter one among these. Okay, shorter means chota. Means, aapko dekhna hai ki dono mein se kaun sa chota hai, right? You can see the letters. Yes. And encircle the shorter. You can see this is shorter. Yes. Now you have to encircle. Means aapko ispe circle karna hai. Okay. You have to encircle the shorter one. Now you can see students. There are two pencils. Right. Now the question is encircle the shorter one. Right. Remember the question. Shorter one. Okay. So which one is shorter? Yes. Very good. This one is shorter. So, what will we do? We will encircle it. We will not tick it. We will encircle it. Okay? Like this. Is it clear? Now, in the B part, tell me which one is shorter? This one or this one? Yes? This one. Very good. What will we do? We will encircle the shorter one. Okay, students? Now, part C, D, E, F. You will do. Okay. They are so simple. You have to just observe the pictures carefully. You have to see which one is shorter. And you have to encircle. Okay. You have to encircle it. Okay, students. Now, come on page number 53. Take out page number. Okay, students. On page number 53. Tick the shorter one and encircle the longer or taller one. Okay, now you have to read the statement carefully that what have to do. Now the question is tick the shorter one. Okay, which one is shorter? You have to tick on it, right? And which one is longer or you can say taller? You have to encircle that. Okay, you have to read the statement carefully first. Okay, beta? Tick the shorter one. Now you have to tick on shorter and you have to encircle the longer one. Now you can see students, this is a cup and this is a your water bottle. Okay. So now tick the shorter. This one is shorter. Yes, cup is shorter than this now. So you have to tick on cup and you have to encircle the longer. This one is longer. So you have to encircle it. Is it clear? Okay. Now you can see part A. There are brushes. Okay, beta. This one is shorter. You can see this one is shorter and this one is longer. Now, what is the question? Tick the shorter means you have to put tick on the shorter one. Okay. You have to put tick on the shorter and you have to encircle the longer one like this. Right. Now in part B, tell me yes. You will tell me now. Okay. Yes. Very good. You will tick on it and encircle on it. Very good. So now part C, D, E and F. Okay, beta. These parts you will do at home. Okay. What will you do? You will tick on the shorter one and you will encircle the longer one. You have to read the statement carefully. Okay. After that, you will do these parts. Okay. So now come on page number 54. On page number 54, the statement is tick the longest or tallest and encircle the shortest. Okay. Now what will you do? You will see the pictures carefully and you will see that there are three images, right? There are three images and you have to put tick on the longest. Which one is longest? Means sabse badi hai jo. उसको आपने टिक करना है राइट एंड विच वन इज शॉर्टेस्ट यू हैव टू एनसर्कल दैट उसको आपने सर्कल करना है ओके स्टूडेंट्स नाउ यू कैन सी देयर आर स्नेक्स यस सो दिस वन इज टॉलेस्ट राइट यू कैन सी दिस वन इज टॉलेस्ट सो वी विल टिक ऑन इट राइट एंड दिस वन इज शॉर्टेस्ट राइट दिस वन इज शॉर्टेस्ट सो व्हाट विल वी डू वी विल एनसर्कल इट ओके स्टूडेंट्स Now, part A, you can see which one is tallest. Yes, tell me which one is tallest. Yes, very good. This one is tallest. What will we do? Tell me. Encircle it. Yes. No. We will tick on it. Right. And now the question is, we will read it again. Tick the longest. Or tallest, right? You can say longest or you can say tallest. The meaning is same. And encircle the shortest. You have to encircle the shortest one. Now, in part A, you can see this one is longest, right? And this one is shortest. So, on the longest object, we will put tick, yes. And on the shortest object, we will What will we do? Tell me. Yes. Yes. We will encircle it. So, in this way, we will encircle it. Right? Now, part B. Which one is tallest? Observe it carefully and tell me which one is tallest. Yes. Very good. This one is tallest. What will we do? We will tick on it or encircle it. Yes, tell me, what will we do? Yes, we will tick on it. Very good. And which one is shortest? This one or this one? Yes, very good. This one is shortest. What will we do? We will encircle it. Right. In this way, we will encircle it. So, students, you have to read the statement carefully, okay? Now, part C, D, E, F, G, H. This is your revision work, okay? You will do it at home. Fine, students. So now, students, we will do maths assignment, okay? I will show you. So you can see select the true statement. Okay, select the true statement. First one is identify the shape. You can see, students, this is a shape. Okay, now tell me what is its shape. Tell me, students. Yes, tell me. Very good. So you can see the all the sides are equal. You can see all the sides are equal. Yes, so what is it? It is square. So the question is select the true statement, right? Select the true statement. So what will you do? You will put tick on A part, that is square, because this is a square, right? Now how many corners are there in the given figure? So you can see, students, this is the shape of a rectangle, and how many corners are there in the given figure? Yes, let's start counting. 1, 2, 3, and 4. There are four corners. So which option is right? This one. Okay, so now, so students, you can see how many sides are there in the given figure. Okay, now you can see this is a triangle, right? It has how many sides are in the triangle? Let's start counting. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so there are three sides. Okay, so now tell me which option is the right option. Yes, yes, option A is the right option. Very good. Now the next one we have, select the false statement. Okay, now you have to observe the pictures and you have to see that which one is the false statement. Okay, now you can see, students, there are two buckets. Yes, bucket A, bucket B. Now you can see the options. Option A is, bucket A is taller. You can see bucket A is taller. Yes or no? Yes. So this statement is true, right? Now move to the next option, that is B. Bucket B is shorter. So you can see B is shorter. So it is also true statement, right? Now option C, both are shorter. No, it is not the right option. It is not the true option. Because you can see one bucket is taller and one bucket is shorter. So now read the statement carefully, that select the false statement. Which one is false? Yes, option C is the right option. In this question, you have to choose, you have to select the false statement, that which one is false, right? Okay, so which one is right option? C, because in the C option, the statement is both are shorter, but one bucket is taller and one bucket is shorter. So both the buckets are not shorter. So C option is the false statement. So we will take on it. Okay, students, hope you understand it. Good. So now, students, you will learn that which unit you can use to measure the length. So students, the length of shorter things means, you can say, things with shorter length can be measured in centimeter. Okay, longer and taller things can be measured in meters. For example, length of a pen will be measured in centimeter, right? Length of a spoon, length of a pencil, that will be measured in centimeters. And like height of a wall, that will be measured in meters, right? So length of your classroom, that will be measured in, yes, meters. Okay, length of your house will be measured in meters. Okay, students. So simply you can say the things with shorter length can be measured in centimeters, and longer and taller lengths can be measured in meters. Hope you clear it. So now the next topic is lighter object and heavier object. First of all, you should know what are lighter objects and what are heavier objects. The heavier objects has more weight. Okay, they have more weight, and the lighter objects have less weight. Okay, now you can see on the screen, students. On the one hand there is school bag. Yes, on the other hand there is watch. Now you can see which object will be heavier. You can easily observe that bag has more weight. Yes, it has more weight, okay, than the watch. So which object is heavier? Bag. Yes. And the question is, encircle the lighter object and tick the heavier object. So what will you do? You will tick on bag and you will encircle the watch. Okay students, the heavier objects has more weight, and the weight is measured in kilograms. The heavy things, which things are heavy, the weight will be measured in kilograms. Okay, the things which are lighter, they have less weight, the weight will be measured in grams. Okay, so you have to observe the things carefully, that which thing is lighter, which thing is heavier, because the heavier things have more weight, okay, and the lighter things have less weight. Okay students, I will give you one example. You can see students, this is a ball. Yes, you can see this is a ball and this is a bat. And now tell me which object is lighter. Tell me which object is lighter. Yes, ball. Ball is lighter object and the bat is heavier object. So in this way you have to observe the objects carefully and you have to choose that which one is lighter and which one is heavier. Okay, now the question is, encircle the lighter object and tick the heavier object. Now what will we do? Yes, we will encircle the lighter object like this, and we will tick on the heavier object like this. Okay, is it clear to all of you? Good. So now you can see students, there is one apple. Okay, the weight of this apple will be measured in grams because it is lighter object. Yes, you can see there is only one apple and the weight of apple is measured in grams. And on the other hand you can see, this is a animal. Which animal is this? Elephant. Yes, the weight of the elephant will be measured in kilograms. Okay students, so hope you understand the topic. Okay, now we will revise capacity. So students, smaller objects will have lesser capacity, right? They hold less liquid, and larger objects will have greater capacity. They can hold more liquid. Now you can see on the screen that on the one side there is spoon and on the other hand there is cup. Okay, now you can see students, spoon. If you see spoon, it is a smaller object. Yes, it will hold lesser capacity, right? It will hold lesser capacity. And on the other hand, that is cup, that is larger object. If we compare it with spoon, so you can see the cup is larger object, so it will hold more capacity. Yes, so the question is, encircle the object which hold less and tick which holds more. So you can see students, spoon is a smaller object, it will hold less capacity, and the cup is a larger object and that will hold more capacity. So you can do this topic easily. You can see this is a spoon, this is a bottle, it will hold more capacity and the spoon will hold less capacity. This is a bucket and this is a glass. So again, it will hold more capacity because it is larger. Yes, but it will hold less capacity because it is small. Okay, students. Now, students, the bigger objects hold more capacity, right? So their capacity is measured in liters. Okay, and the smaller objects hold less capacity, so their capacity is measured in milliliters. Now you can see in part A, this is cold drink bottle. You can see, now you can see, students, it is smaller object, right? And it will hold less capacity. So the object which hold less capacity will be measured in milliliters. Okay, so we will tick on milliliters. Now on the other hand, you can see this is tank. Okay, and you can see, students, it is a bigger object. Okay, it will hold more capacity. So which unit we will use? Yes, liter or milliliter, because it is big object, the capacity is measured in liters. Okay, right. Now we will revise geometry. Okay, students, you can see on the screen, this is a square. This is a square because all the sides are equal. Okay, all the sides are equal, so this is a square. And if I say, how many corners does it have? Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4. How many corners are there? 4 corners, right? 4 corners. If I say, how many sides are there? 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 sides, right? And this is a square. All the sides are equal, right? Now, this is a circle. This is a circle. What are the spelling of circle? C-I-R-C-L-E, circle. And what are the spelling of square? S-Q-U-A-R-E, square. And in the circle, there is no side, okay? Zero side, yes. Zero side, zero corner, right, students? Zero side, zero corner. There is no straight line in the circle. Okay, so zero side and zero corner. In the square, there are 4 corners and 4 sides. In the circle, there is no side, there is no corner. Okay, students. Now, B part. This is a rectangle. This is a rectangle. Let's revise the spelling. R-E-C-T-A-N-G-L-E, rectangle. Okay, so how many sides are there? 1, 2, 3, and 4. There are 4 sides. And how many corners? 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 corners and 4 sides. Okay, there are 4 corners and 4 sides. 4 corners. Now, this is a triangle. This is a triangle. Let's revise the spelling. T-R-I-A-N-G-L-E, triangle. And it has 3 sides. It has 3 sides. 1, 2, 3. Okay? 3 sides. And three corners. Okay, you can see students, 1, 2, 3, three corners. Okay, right. Now let's revise the shapes. Okay, so what is this? This is a circle. This is a circle. Very good. What is this? This is a rectangle because opposite sides are equal. And what is this? This is a square. Yes, all the sides are equal. Good. What is this? This is a triangle. This is a triangle. What is this? Yes, cylinder, circle, yes, rectangle, very good. What is this? Yes, what is this? Cuboid, yes, this is a cuboid because all the faces are in rectangular shape. You know what is the difference between cube and cuboid? In the cube, all the faces are in square shape. And in the cuboid, all the faces are in rectangular shape. So, this is also a cuboid. And what is this? This is a cube. This is a cube. Okay. So, this is again cylinder, circle, triangle, square. So, students, this is about identification of shapes. Okay. So, this is all about your tier 5 syllabus. So, revise it carefully. Okay, students. So, now we have covered all the topics. Okay, students. So, now you will revise all the topics. Okay. So, all the best for your tier 5 exam. Okay. Okay, students. So, now take out your diaries. Now take out your diaries. Write down the date. Write down the date and write down the homework. Revise measurement and geometry for tier 5 test. Okay, test will be on 10th February. Okay, students, write down the homework. Write down. Have you written the homework? Okay. So, students, all the best for your tier 5 test. Okay, revise all the topics. Okay, students, have a nice day. Bye.